to live. Especially with purple hair. She dyed her hair purple. She hates it. I didn't go out of my way to look special. Mama didn't try to dussy up. Because she's not here to put on airs. So for any of you who don't like my mama, or are always looking for ammunition to try to poke holes in whatever she's doing to try to paint us to be some person she's not. Because she triggers your own wounding and your own insecurity. She's getting ready to give you all the ammunition you need! Because she's getting ready to share something real personal with y'all. And for any of you who think this is about ego for me, you're getting ready to know right here it ain't. Because this is not a proud moment what I'm getting ready to share. But it's a necessary moment. Because the spirits, when the spirit mama just left her doctor's office with some results, and the spirits told her, you better go share your good news with the people. Mama's old ego kicked in and said, hell no, you don't. You're not gonna share that shit. You don't even tell them about that. And spirit said, are you an angelic messenger of the spirit here to help? Or are you here to work your ego and see if you can make yourself look good? Are you only going to share the things that project you in a positive light? Or are you going to be real? So mama's going to be real. And she wants you to know how hard this is for her to say. Hard for her to accept consequences of past mistakes. And hard for her to tell. It's very important you understand why I'm telling you this. It's not for the people that are going to pass judgment on me. It's not for the people that are going to paint me in the wrong light because of past life lessons which molded and shaped me into the amazing person I am now. This is for people who made mistakes. Well, not even mistakes, who lived life and been through shit. To forge them in the fire, to make them and mold them in the person they're supposed to be. This video is to help those people. I'm going to share with you something real personal about my life. And please forward this message to people. Hear that plane? Who need to hear it. And let this be evidence to all y'all that this ain't about ego for me. Hear that plane? This is about helping people. Giving you strength, to push, to not think any man or miracle ain't possible through the good Lord. Don't matter what you've done in your past, so let me tell y'all. So, I was an intravenous heroin addict. I used to shoot the heroin for like 10 years. Got clean about 8 years ago. But before, see, I had my dad for a boy. And I don't like it. It did weird shit. I don't know. I'm gonna go fix it. But anyway, that's mama's old ego. She's the one to explain why she looks crazy. Fuck that. So, before I quit doing heroin, though, I was told I contacted HIPSA. And, gratefully, based on the advances of medical modern medicine, it's completely curable. Completely curable. I was diagnosed with it about a decade ago, and after I quit the heroin, I was hitting the wine. And yes, I'm having a glass of wine today, like drink happy thoughts, because I was celebrating. Because I got good news. I got real good news to share. And I'm sharing it for you to pass it along to people who've gone through the same stuff mom is. So they know that there's hope, right? It's all good. So I'm going to tell y'all, as much as I don't want to tell y'all, Jimmy, Mama don't want to tell y'all this. Mama say, hell no, spirits, I ain't going to tell them people that. Spirits say, whose work are you doing? You doing your ego's work or you doing our work? So Mama say, well, I'm doing your work. They say, well, you better be down. So basically, Mama has known for like a decade, she had HIPSA. She knows drinking is the worst thing for HIPSA because it'll cause cirrhosis. Well, after she got off the heroin, she was hitting the bottom. She used to drink them daiquiris. Louisiana has these drive-through daiquiris. She always used to get you a daiquiri and go jelly shots, go have it. But she liked them white Russians. Well, so probably, I don't know, first 5 years after I got off the heroin, I drink good a little bit. And then I got all that shit now too, you know. And that's another thing. Those of you going with drug addiction, weaning yourself off be gentle with yourself. Be kind. If you gotta scale yourself back from shooting heroin to have a glass of wine, that's okay. Be gentle on yourself. You ain't gotta be a saint overnight. You ain't. So anyway. So now that I got my life in order, and I got this little boy, the little disabled boy to take care of, I started thinking, oh shit. What have I done to myself? I didn't let this go untreated for 10 years and drank for like 5 of them. I probably got the cirrhosis. I probably died on this. I was gonna take care of that kid. So his parents said, sister, you got health insurance. Go get it checked out. This shit's gonna be terrible. You're good. Hear that, bro? I still waited. I was nervous. So this year, you know, having to take care of myself, the crows are coming. I decided to go. And, me and Lucy, see, I was supposed to go on the first to get the results of the blood work and all that. I didn't want to go. I was scared. I said, fuck that. I ain't going. And, so we had to go tonight. I like, that's my last set play with me from school. Bring my little lucky charm. That's my little lucky charm. Ooh, we celebrate. Thank you, Spurs. And, anyway, so. Yo, just, if you're texting me, because mama's old ego's wanting to cut in here any minute, and interrupt me. And when it's real hard for mama to talk about something, she lets me come through a little hairless. Because when she tells the story through my voice, it's you know, through my perspective, it's all kind of cool. It's not that big of a deal. So, and it's hard for mama to talk about. So even though she's laughing about it, she's joking. It's like, mommy, ain't nothing about what I'm telling y'all about. Mama made a lot of mistakes. And not even mistakes. You know, if you have a high calling, high purpose, you're supposed to go through a bunch of shit, because how else are you going to be able to relate to people? Shit, when I was a drug addict, I went to a substance abuse place. I didn't want to talk to nobody who never had a drug addiction. I want to talk to somebody better than trenches. He knows! So it's because that made mama go through a lot of shit so that she can relate to a lot of people, so she can help a lot of people. So don't look at things that you've done in your life that society deems inappropriate. That's not silly, inappropriate. That's life experience. It's for your resume. This is to serve your purpose. This is to do your work. Love yourself. Love yourself through. Anyway, so. We didn't want to go that long, did we? We didn't. So let's sit play hooky. And, me, Mom, and Seth, we're in. My God. If that doctor didn't go into that room and look at my liver, ultrasound is a girl. You ain't got no cirrhosis. You ain't got no tube. You can't even tell something's wrong with your liver. He got my blood work. He was off and he said, girl, how long you done had this? I said, about a decade. He said, what? How's that possible? How you never look so good? How you look so good, girl? You good. Hear that, girl? He said, sister, we're going to give you a pill. Then your insurance is going to cover. You're going to take that for 8 weeks. Might make you sleepy. And then you're going to be 90% chance cured. Cured. So mama comes to you tonight for you to share this with the intravenous drug users in your family. Get that crow. This is why mother's putting herself on blast right now, because this is not a proud moment. This is not a proud moment. Mama's not very proud to come tell you this. Get that crow. She had to fight it really hard, her ego. It's going to take a minute to post it. Mama don't claim to be perfect. Here, my cronus, my spirit guides, here, my moral support for mama. It's mama didn't want to tell y'all this. The spirit said he got you.
Because they've got a bunch of people who can't forgive themselves for the things that they've done in the past, and they think that the mistakes that they made in the past, that the good Lord can't send a miracle to remedy. So this message ain't for you judges, you haters. You people follow me but never comment, never got nothing nice to say, but always nosy to see what I'm doing. So this is what I'm doing. I'm healing. I'm sharing it with my community to help them heal. For those of you, hear a crow, who have someone in your family who suffered from drug addiction, especially intravenous drug use, share this video with them. Any manner of miracle is possible through the heavens, and it's completely curable.
It's completely curable. It's not even a big deal no more. Right?
I love the supernatural very much to have a show here. Do you want to see him?
See if I can see him. I'll flash a little picture of him in the crow fader. Look, there he goes! There he goes, Mr. Brad! There he went! Thank you, Spirit God! Good boy! You better keep squawking till I post it, because I ain't posted it yet. No, I just don't ever do it. I'm a good, obedient little sheep. I mean, a good, obedient little steward, because I ain't a sheep. No, let's make up a thing. Life would happen to me, you're not a sheep. You know, you're not
living your purpose, living your mission, and you're following the herd, you are a sheep. Okay, so that was bad. Okay. So, this video ain't part of mine.
This video is to show y'all I don't make these videos because I'm working my ego. These videos are to show y'all I'm really here to help. Even at the expense of looking stupid, talking like a child. If it helps you better to see your world through the lens of the eyes of a child. And to put all my personal business on blast. To show you we all go through shit. I'm just a messenger. And I'm just here to share my personal experiences with you to help you overcome your own struggles in your own life. I'm just here to help you find a message helpful, great. You find it's an excuse to pass judgment on the great karma will serve you just fine. The heavens know where that you know. Many blessings.